footprints. Hospitals should take footprints of babies at birth or at the time of admission in NICU or any other department of the hospital. The footprints should be signed by at least one parent or a close relative as a token of acceptance of the identity of the baby. Patient's wristband. All the patients should be provided with wristbands that should mention the patient's name, UHID number, and the date of admission. The wristbands should be waterproof and non-tearable. Ophthalmologists can put the band on the same side of the surgery. Like, for right eye surgery, put the band on the right hand. 6 hours of medicine administration. The nursing staff should ensure compliance with 6 hours prior to medication administration. The 6 hours are: the first hour is the right patient. The second hour is the right time. The third hour is the right medicine. The fourth hour is the right route. The fifth hour is the right dose. The sixth hour is the right documentation. Nursing over. At the change of shift, nursing staff should give over cot by cot and in front of the patients and not at the nursing station. Red bulb outside OT. A signboard mentioning "Do not enter if the red light is on" should be placed prominently. The bulb should be switched on while the surgery is in progress and switched off thereafter or during idle time, just like we have watched in our good old movies. Numbering OT. All the OTs should be numbered. The size of each OT should be mentioned as shown. The chemicals used for fumigation along with their dilution should be displayed. The hospital should have separate fumigation, narcotics and OT register and a separate surveillance report file. Temperature and humidity of OT. The hospital should record the temperature and humidity at the beginning of the day. The temperature recommended for general surgery is 22 degrees Celsius with a humidity of around 55%.